likely during the afternoon. North and west, again, Seattle, a low of 42. A couple of showers here and there, especially in the Olympic range to the west and perhaps over towards Mount Rainier. Otherwise, we'll have some sunshine, a high of 55. Might want to keep the umbrella handy as some of those passing showers will be in and around the area. All right, we'll take a look at the jet stream right now. Basically a flat flow on Wednesday that will keep the warmth temporarily working its way up along the eastern seaboard, and a bit of moisture coming in along the west, but nothing terribly unusual about this. On Saturday, perhaps a few light showers, east coast and a few other areas, but no major organized storm centers seem very likely at this time. In fact, we'll take you through the maps right now. More or less seasonable temperatures after a cool Wednesday. The April sun will start to work on that chilly air mass in the central Great Lakes. Look for a bit of a warm-up there. High temperatures on Friday, central and southern states, back to the 70s and 80s. And of course, the desert's starting to warm up at this time of the year in the southwest. And coastal areas of California will be on the cool side, but not unusually so. A couple of scattered showers, likely with some heavier rains early Wednesday throughout New England, as that southern system finally makes its influence known in the northeastern U.S. Lower Ohio Valley and the Great Plains looking dry at that point. Thursday and on towards Friday, it looks like a few isolated showers into the central Ohio Valley. The northeast should be dry at that point. And the beginning of the weekend, except for a few renegade showers in the northeast, looking dry, the west coast may have a few showers in the Pacific Northwest.
Now, your local forecast, accurate and dependable from the Weather Channel.
To improve the way you sleep for less money, get free facts by mail about the Craftmatic Model 2 adjustable bed. Look, this is the quality adjustable bed that actually costs 50% less than these quality nationally advertised brand name flatbeds. That's right, for 50% less than these quality flatbeds, you can sleep on a bed that adjusts electrically to all these relaxing positions. Read in bed, watch TV in bed, elevate your feet, support your back, and fall asleep in virtually ideal comfort, and at a price that's 50% less than the cost of these quality flatbeds. 50% less. Get our free catalog about this remarkable adjustable bed by mail.
Hi, I'd like your free catalog.
Call for a free catalog now. There's absolutely no obligation.
Call toll-free 1-800-BED-9115. That's 1-800-BED-9115, toll-free.
Take a look at boat and beach conditions across the Northwest. We'll show you a satellite picture of this part of the country. We have a frontal system that's swinging on in, doesn't have a lot of moisture, but it is going to bring more of an onshore flow to the west coast as we head on into Tuesday. Winds, west, northwest, up toward the north, around that high pressure building in behind the front will bring some gustier winds to the north central coast of California, but farther south, an onshore flow will be rather light. Here's the way it's looking if you're going to be heading out. For tomorrow, notice the winds, west to southwest in Washington, not all that strong. But behind, just behind that front, the winds are going to be out of the north to northwest, a little gustier around the San Francisco Bay Area. Small craft advisories are in effect for Tuesday. As we head south, though, the winds do get lighter out ahead of that front. Variable in the morning, onshore flow as you get into the afternoon. Now, the offshore flow won't be quite as strong. We're probably going to start with a little low clouds and fog in the morning, but by afternoon, plenty of sunshine in the southwest, the coast of California, but kind of a mixture of clouds and sunshine for the northwest, and, well, nothing more than a stray shower. Shouldn't be that bad. Stay tuned. We'll have a detailed look at your hometown forecast.
This spring, you can learn all the ground rules for gardening on the Weather Channel. How will your garden grow? Watch our Garden Weather, featuring accurate planting calendars, telling you just when the time is ripe for planting. Our frost-free advisories will keep you up to date on the last freezes and the threat of spring frosts. And anyone can have a green thumb with our handy tips for gardening and lawn care. You'll get more than just your common garden variety weather when you watch Garden Weather on the Weather Channel. Weather you can always turn to.
If you're going to be traveling on Tuesday, we'll let you know what you might need to pack with these destination forecasts. Stay tuned. Up shortly, we'll have a detailed look at your hometown forecast. Then we'll hone in on the West Coast, see what new storms might be brewing as we head into Tuesday. Stay tuned.
The Lion says save America for your country, for yourself. Save America with Dreyfus 100% U.S. Treasury Money Market Fund. 100% U.S. Treasuries, the safest portfolio investment of all. What's that? Your money's dozing away in a bank money market account. Wake up to higher yields. Week after week since the fund began, Dreyfus 100% U.S. Treasury has returned more than the bank money market average. Even more if you pay state or local income tax on your bank account, because this unique Dreyfus fund is free of income tax in 49 states. Sorry, Tennessee. For today's yield, call 1-800-843-8169. And we'll send you information, a prospectus. Checking? Free checking. Invest in Dreyfus 100% U.S. Treasury Money Market Fund. Call 1-800-843-8169. Don't bank on it. Dreyfus on it.
Test the water before you hit the beach. Select from over 150 beach forecasts. 95 cents a minute. Call 1-900-WEATHER.
Take weight off and keep it off for good. Nordic Track introduces the weight loss guarantee.
By using my Nordic Track, I lost 40 pounds and 6 inches from my waist.
Hundreds of thousands of people have taken weight off and kept it off with Nordic Track. And we're so confident you'll lose weight too, we guarantee it. Try Nordic Track in your own home. You'll lose at least 10 pounds in 60 days or return it for a refund.
With my Nordic Track, in only 6 weeks, I lost 16 pounds and I went from a size 10 to a size 4.
Research shows Nordic Track's total body workout burns more calories than exercises that only work your legs. And Nordic Track raises your metabolism, so you keep burning more calories when your workout is over.
After I switched to Nordic Track, I lost 15 pounds and I feel great.
We'll guarantee that you'll lose at least 10 pounds in 60 days or your money back. Call now for a free video and brochure. Ask about our 60-day weight loss guarantee.
If you're about to travel, watch the 5-Day Business Planner here on the Weather Channel at 20 minutes after every hour. You get a comprehensive national report that covers the forecast over the next 5 days. Watch the 5-Day Business Planner coming up soon on the Weather Channel. Now, your local forecast, accurate and dependable from the Weather Channel.
major problems coming up on the West Coast over the next several days. Perhaps a little bit cooler here and there, but this little cold front swinging on through central California is coming in on cat's feet. Not too much in the way of precipitation, just a few light showers, and mainly those are occurring in the higher elevations. Here's the cold front. It's a weak one, just a few scattered showers in and around it. May tend to enhance the onshore wind a little bit, so your high temperatures during the weekend, which had no trouble reaching the 70s and 80s, even near coastal areas, probably gone for a while. Still, the weather will be fairly nice, some areas of fog near the coast. Here's a nice broad view of our satellite picture, some breaks showing up around Quileute. Coast still fairly clear here, down to Redmond and into Portland, and on towards the north and south into the Columbia River Basin. The clouds a little bit heavier over the Cascade Range and a few light showers around Klamath Falls and on towards the south. Monday's high temperature, Seattle by Puget Sound, 60 degrees, Quileute 55, Astoria 57. So the winds, again, cooling things down near coastal areas. Coos Bay down to 58 for high, while Klamath Falls and Burns got on towards nearly 70 degrees, and the temperatures remaining cool at this hour. Eugene 49, Burns 55, and Boise a warm 65. Snowmelt continuing in the mountains, the Bitterroots of Idaho, and also in the high Sierra Nevada. Reno, a nice pleasant 76 in Carson City, and all the locations down Route 395 were on the warm side as well. Look at Merced's high, 92, as we follow the Merced River into Lake Tahoe area. Actually, Yosemite National Park, they had a nice warm day as well. Now it's 72 at Merced, Fresno 77, and San Francisco cooling down a bit. Some fog beginning to creep in, 57 degrees in Monterey. Out in the peninsula, a similar temperature as well. You can almost see the cold front showing up very nicely with this band of clouds heading off towards the south and east. And here's the Sierra Nevada with its snow cover still pretty much intact, but the elevation at which snow is found on the ground getting higher and higher as April goes along, the snow melt continuing. And you can also see the fog beginning to show up from about the Crescent City on towards the south, just about down to Cape Mendocino, and that process will continue. Friday's high temperature is 89 Bakersfield. Actually, Monday's high temperature is 89 at Bakersfield. 71, the temperature now in Los Angeles, Oceanside, 64 in San Diego, 70. Elsewhere across the country, well, some of the quietest weather for the time being is from roughly the Mississippi Valley on west, still some snow into eastern Nebraska, up to 5 inches of heavy, wet snow on the ground at this point, unusually late storm, continuing to chug off towards the north and east. Thunderstorms perhaps slightly quieter now than they were earlier, but this front still has to go a great distance before it will clear the coast. We do think there's a very strong chance of more powerful storms developing during Tuesday in the southeast. So we hope you'll join us frequently. Dale will be along with your next five-day outlook coming up next.
You rode the same rides, ate the same junk, got the same heartburn. But his antacid's different from yours. His Tums has calcium. Most antacids don't. Regular Rolaids uses an aluminum salt. This uses aluminum and magnesium. So does this. Of all these, only Tums helps wipe out heartburn and gives you calcium you need every day.
Something my body needs anyway. I like that.
Calcium-rich Tums.
Only one adult cereal could be this much fun to eat. Basic Four. A colorful mix of lightly toasted flakes, sweet and tangy fruits, and crunchy nuts. Splash on cold milk and you get something tasty from each of the four food groups. Basic Four, the adult cereal. With a taste that never grew up.
You get more than just your common garden variety weather when you watch Garden Weather, right here on the Weather Channel. Weather you can always turn to.
Taking a look at your five-day business planner. Very stormy to start. Things should quiet down a bit as we round out the week. This storm system, very strong one, is going to be slow to lift northward. Still going to bring enough cold air around it. Wet snow will continue to be the problem. It'll really be piling up from the Siouxland right on up along the Dakotas and Minnesota border. Looks like the best area of snow. Ahead of the system, a lot of moisture in place. The front chugging along sluggishly. And showers and thunderstorms, most likely from the Ohio Valley into the southeast part of the country. Again, some could be severe, but the storm should start weakening. It's getting kind of old and stale, and therefore the chance for severe weather not quite as high as we head on through Tuesday. There'll be thunderstorms with the frontal system itself. Some could be on the nasty side. Still, though, slow to move and just throwing that moisture back into that air that's just cold enough for the wet snow across the plains. weak front, maybe a few scattered showers in the mountains of the west. The main thing this front will do, turn the winds more onshore, so it won't be quite as warm along the California coast during the day on Tuesday, but inland sections will be quite mild. Storm just chugging along into the east. Ahead of it, very warm, soupy air. Nighttime lows not that low at all, but very cold air coming down behind that system, helping to support the snow in the plains. And the coldest of the days will be Tuesday. The storm kind of leaving, the cold air really plunging south on northerly winds. But after that, that storm starts to retreat and move up into Canada, weakening as it does so. And so the cold air should retreat with it. So a little chilly air swinging around it on Wednesday, but look, by Thursday, already the southeast really warming on up. Cold air is going to want to hold along the Great Lakes and northeast. Southwest looking great too, although an onshore flow will make for some slightly cooler temperatures along the coast. But even there, looking great. So temperatures looking quite nice as we head on into the weekend. As far as your precipitation, the storm system's lifting on up. Most of the rain in New England on Wednesday, everyone else starts to clear except for the upper Mississippi Valley and Great Lakes. Some rain, still some snow showers lingering, but the storm is going to be departing by Wednesday. Weak front coming through the Rockies now gets into the plains, but this one, in contrast to its predecessor, is going to be a fairly fast-moving system. It's not going to have a lot of time to get a lot of moisture. The result, some rather light showers as it moves its way eastbound. A new weak front brings some rain to the northwest. We were just talking about that real big major storm system coming into the east. We'll be tracking that for tomorrow, but tracking some other things, Tom.
That's right. Some nice quiet weather on the west coast. Nice day to take a trip down Route 1 or perhaps take a trip to Yosemite National Park. We'll be along with your Pacific Regional forecast coming up next.
Attention homeowners. Coming your way now. Special savings on Sears durable chain-link fencing. Help make your yard safe and secure while you enjoy Sears special savings of 50% on selected chain-link fence fabric with the installation of an exclusive Sears Armadillo 10 fence system. Call this number now for your free in-home estimate. Save 50% on selected lines of chain-link fence fabric. Heavy-duty chain-link fencing, available in your choice of heights. This is a limited-time offer, so be sure to call Sears today. Enjoy greater privacy and peace of mind. Have Sears install a chain-link fence now. Get your free in-home estimate and get satisfaction guaranteed or your money back. Call now before this offer is come and gone. For all your home improvements, you can count on Sears, the most trusted name around the house.
Well, in contrast to what's happening in the east, the west coast is enjoying some very nice, quiet weather. A few problem areas, a few light showers Tuesday morning, but no major problems for San Francisco or Los Angeles for the morning commute. This cold front will go by pretty quietly, a few areas of light snow in the higher elevations. Otherwise, just a wind shift around to the north and northwest that might make for some slightly cooler temperatures near the coast. A look at your overnight low temperatures. Nothing unusual about this. There will be some clouds creeping in near the coast. The Civic Center of Los Angeles down to about 60, perhaps a little bit cooler as we head on towards the south. Places like Del Mar and Pacifica and Oceanside down to 55, and San Diego about 61. Afternoon highs still should be in the lower 70s, nice and warm and dry. Pretty nice beach weather coming up too. 79 for a high in Los Angeles, even Santa Barbara, a beautiful day. High temperature near 70, and by Mission Bay in San Diego, nearly 80 degrees. Of course, the Canyonlands inland is where we'll see some of the warmer temperatures. Similar situation farther on towards the north, San Francisco, a high temperature near 66. Of course, as you work over towards Oakland and Walnut Creek and into Sacramento, temperatures progressively warmer, a nice afternoon in the high 70s. Fresno, about 84. Cooler, somewhat damp in the Pacific Northwest, a few showers, Seattle and Portland, with a high temperature reaching the upper 50s. Quileute, wind off the ocean there, 55 for a high. Still a few thunderstorms around. We'll take a look at radars coming up next.
Avoid unpleasant surprises when you travel. Watch international weather. Accurate weather forecast for Europe at 41 after the hour, every day on the Weather Channel.
Radar potpourri of weather, showers, thunderstorms, a lot of moisture surging north, enough cold air, heavy wet snow from eastern South Dakota into eastern Nebraska and western Iowa on the west coast in good shape, dry weather there. Take a little closer look on into the southeast part of the country. And one band of thunder showers, heaviest in western South Carolina, continues to move east-northeast, but a lot of moisture, still a lot of energy coming east. Looks like another line of showers and thunderstorms developing Mississippi, Alabama, and they'll be tracking east as we go on through the nighttime hours tonight. Some storms, too, down on into Florida. A little closer look shows the heaviest cells near Greenville, Spartanburg, but more intense ones growing despite the time of day, western Alabama and eastern Mississippi. So it's not over yet. The front's still very, very far to the west. Heading north, the showers decreasing in the Great Lakes, but into the colder air, rain changes to wet snow. The Siouxland on south to Omaha causing road problems.
Weather Channel, weather you can always turn to for accurate, dependable weather forecasts 24 hours a day.
Taking a look at satellite view of the west, we see clouds from the Intermountain region down on into central California. Those associated with a weak frontal system, and not much along with that. There's been a few sprinkles in the northwest today. And as that moves into the Intermountain region, maybe a few scattered showers on Tuesday. But the main influence this front will have is it'll turn that offshore flow into an onshore flow, so temperatures along the coast not nearly as warm as they were yesterday. They cooled a little bit today, and that trend will continue. And with the onshore flow, even a little bit of fog and low clouds during the early morning hours, even down into California, a little thicker fog as you head to the northwest, but maybe a little sunshine. But still the air a bit unstable offshore. That may kick off a stray shower or two in the northwest, but no big storms, just a front that's strong enough to bring the winds back in off the ocean and cool things down just a bit. On our current weather map, we can show you where that front is currently, and we're going to take you through the forecast, let you see what will happen to it in time. You can see the front, the clouds with it, and a few stray showers, really not amounting to much. Most places reporting just partly cloudy skies in the Pacific Northwest. Temperatures today, even though warm, not quite as warm as yesterday, really cooled down in San Francisco as that front moved through. LA not quite as hot as the last couple of days, and that trend toward cooler weather will continue as the frontal system spreads its way onto the south. Currently, it's still 71 at Bakersfield, Los Angeles 71, 84 in Palm Springs. They were up to 96 today. It was a warm one, to say the least. Heading on up the coast, 57 at San Francisco, Merced 72, still a little mild in Fresno at 77 degrees, while Blue Canyon in the mountains down to 51 degrees. Seattle at 50 with partly cloudy skies, Salem at 52, and looking at Burns coming in at 55 degrees. So while this front's not doing much in the west, big storm in the nation's midsection, bringing with it a cold rain and even snow, yes, heavy snow in eastern Nebraska, and here it is late April. Meanwhile, as the cold air coming around this system is producing the snow, it's clashing into a lot of moisture streaming out of the Gulf of Mexico, and the result of that has been some heavy showers and thunderstorms throughout the southeast, and it looks like they're going to be in the forecast for still another day or so. Let's show you the latest radar. We'll kind of pinpoint where the most active weather is. One band of showers and thunderstorms from Ohio down on into eastern Georgia and Florida, but more bands of thunderstorms developing as the air is still unstable, and even another disturbance in West Texas, a few light showers there. But as that hits the moisture, tomorrow could still be quite active in the southeast part of the country. Rain showers wrapping into cold rain and snow in the nation's heartland. A little closer look. Heaviest of the first band of storms in the upstate of South Carolina, just to the west of Greenville, Spartanburg. Also some other heavier storms north over the Orlando area, south of Gainesville. Here's your next line of showers and thunderstorms developing. Western Alabama, eastern Mississippi, and showers building in the northern Gulf will kind of get sucked up ahead of this system, so we could be dealing with a fair amount of rain in the southeast part of the country tomorrow morning. Some of that rain locally heavy. Had some thunder showers up in the Great Lakes. Those are dying down now as we're losing the daytime heating. But a chilly rain evolves into snow and sleet in southeastern South Dakota toward Omaha, Nebraska. Reports of upwards of 9 inches of wet snow on the ground. So some snow covered in slick roads there. Let's take a look at our forecast as we look on into the western part of the country. We'll show you what's going to happen with that front. It'll continue to press southeast. Again, a few scattered showers, but mainly more of an onshore flow. A little cooler, maybe some clouds in the morning in Southern California. A little brisk for boaters around the San Francisco Bay Area tomorrow. Otherwise, just the low clouds coming in along the coast tomorrow, and the onshore flow will keep it from getting quite as warm as it did during the day today. San Francisco Bay, 53 to start out, getting up to 66. Partly sunny skies, at least, a little clouds in the morning. Partly cloudy in the northwest, maybe a stray shower, especially in western Washington, but otherwise a pretty nice day. Let's see what the forecast holds as we head toward the weekend, and we'll start you off with the jet stream. This big storm in the nation's midsection now, weakening substantially as it moves north. We turn into more of a zonal flow, and with that, a couple of weak systems, one moving on into the east, another one along the west coast by Saturday. So here are the details of the forecast for you. Behind the system, cold air to start, but as the storm retreats, temperatures moderate. So some nice temperatures in the east as we head into the weekend, and temperatures in the west staying pretty comfortable as well, 80s and 90s, and overall, pretty nice weather pattern for most of the country as we head into the weekend with some comfortable afternoon temperatures. There's your storm bringing rain in New England on Wednesday, maybe some scattered rain and snow showers behind it. That storm, though, is history by Thursday. A weak front comes into the plains, not much moisture, just a few isolated showers with that as it makes its way toward the east coast. Then a new trough comes on into the west, and with that, a few scattered showers in the northwest as we look into Saturday. Stay tuned for your local forecast.
It's the time to rely on weather features, which only the Weather Channel can bring. What does this season have in store for you? Spring Weather Update provides conditions on changing temperatures and chances of precipitation. Planning your weekend? Catch the Weekend Outlook for the extended forecast. Enjoy the shore? Boat and Beach Report gives you a thorough forecast on all water, wind, and sun conditions. Springtime and the Weather Channel. Every hour, blossoming with unique weather features.
The Michelin Driver's Report takes a look at the weather along the nation's major river states. 54 minutes past the hour, every hour on the Weather Channel. Weather you can always turn to.
Now, your local forecast, accurate and dependable from the Weather Channel.
Says save America for your country, for yourself. Save America with Dreyfus 100% U.S. Treasury Money Market Fund. 100% U.S. Treasuries, the safest portfolio investment of all. What's that? Your money's dozing away in a bank money market account. Wake up to higher yields. Week after week since the fund began, Dreyfus 100% U.S. Treasury has returned more than the bank money market average. Even more if you pay state or local income tax on your bank account, because this unique Dreyfus fund is free of income tax in 49 states. Sorry, Tennessee. For today's yield, call 1-800-843-8169. And we'll send you information, a prospectus. Checking? Free checking. Invest in Dreyfus 100% U.S. Treasury Money Market Fund. Call 1-800-843-8169. Don't bank on it. Dreyfus on it.
Parents rely on school day forecasts from the Weather Channel to help them decide what their children should wear. See us before you see them off. The Weather Channel. Weather you can always turn to.
Nice day to come up and enjoy some of the nice sunshine in California. Tuesday, a little bit of a foggy start perhaps in some coastal areas from Cape Mendocino, maybe down to San Francisco, and out to Monterey. This weak cold front's pushing on towards the south. Mainly the showers will be behind it, and they won't be particularly heavy, so the morning commute or any travel plans you may have in the central and southern part of the state should be basically pretty dry. The front going by may kick up a little bit of dust and sand in desert locations in the afternoon, as the winds will pick up a bit, and a bit of cloudiness will greet you near the Civic Center in Los Angeles and Oceanside. Afternoon high temperatures, though, will be reaching the 70s once again. Pretty nice beach weather coming up, or if you're heading towards Palm Springs to enjoy a round of golf, a high of 96. Of course, doesn't feel quite as bad as it would be farther east because the humidity is so very low. Barstow 90 up there on Route 395. The trip up the east side of the Sierra Nevada, looking pretty dry, too. Lake Tahoe down to about 34 by morning with an afternoon high in the lower 60s. Nice weather for some spring skiing there. Sacramento 77, Red Bluff in the 70s as well. And even coastal areas, despite a bit of an onshore wind, should be at least tolerable with a high of 66. North and west, any showers confined to Portland on north to Quileute. They won't perhaps make it a rainy day, but keep the umbrella handy as there will be a few showers with highs in the 50s.
Hi, I'm Al Michaels for Quicken, the world's number one selling financial software and the fastest, easiest way to organize your finances. Quicken gets you through your financial work in no time. It pays bills, tracks investments, cuts tax time, And it's simple. If you can use a checkbook, you can use Quicken because your screen looks exactly like your checkbook. Type in the payee, amount, and Quicken does the rest. Every transaction categorized. So with the stroke of a key, you get detailed reports like income and expenses, net worth, and more. You know exactly how much you spend by category each month. And it's fast. It reconciles my bank statement in 2 minutes. So put yourself in control with Quicken now.
Quicken's price is $69.95, but call 1-800-866-1114 to try Quicken for 30 days for just $8. If you're not satisfied, mail back this card. Quicken is yours to keep. We won't charge you the $61.95 balance. Call now.
Take it from me. With Quicken, you're organized.
Did you know that used motor oil can be recycled? Yet most do-it-yourself oil changers dump it on the ground or down the storm drain, both of which are direct routes to our lakes and streams. In fact, crankcase drainings account for almost half the pollution in our harbors and waterways. Recycling the oil doesn't take much extra effort. Simply transfer the oil from the drain pan into milk cartons, or use one of these specially designed pans that double as a container for transporting the oil. Any of these make it easy to get the oil to a recycler. Most full-service stations and oil change services have their used motor oil collected for reprocessing, so a phone call or two should locate one that will accept yours. Even if you don't change your own oil, you can still make a difference by making sure the professional service you use recycles. These Earth Answers from the Weather Channel.
Call the Weather Channel Connection, 1-900-WEATHER. For just 95 cents a minute, you can connect and get the weather for over 900 cities worldwide.
To improve the way you sleep for less money, get free facts by mail about the Craftmatic Model 2 adjustable bed. Look, this is the quality adjustable bed that actually costs 50% less than these quality nationally advertised brand name flatbeds. That's right, for 50% less than these quality flatbeds, you can sleep on a bed that adjusts electrically to all these relaxing positions. Read in bed, watch TV in bed, elevate your feet, support your back, and fall asleep in virtually ideal comfort, and at a price that's 50% less than the cost of these quality flatbeds. 50% less. Get our free catalog about this remarkable adjustable bed by mail.
Hi, I'd like your free catalog.
Call for a free catalog now. There's absolutely no obligation.
Call toll-free 1-800-BED-9115. That's 1-800-BED-9115, toll-free.
You're watching the Weather Channel for accurate forecasts at your convenience. Weather you can always turn to. Now, your local forecast, accurate and dependable from the Weather Channel.
pressure, have a banana. To prevent a stroke, eat lots of potatoes. Want to know the secrets to really feeling good? Then you need to know what foods can help make you well and what foods can keep you healthy. Now leading nutritionists have put it all in one important book, The Healing Foods. I'm Joanne D'Agostino, nutritional consultant to Prevention Magazine Health Books. I'm also a registered nurse, so I know the healing foods can help dramatically improve your health and well-being. Over 450 pages, the healing foods that can help prevent over 65 illnesses and conditions from colds to cholesterol.
Call now for the healing foods. Try it absolutely free for 21 days. Then if you choose to keep it, we'll bill you in three easy installments of only $8.99. Plus, you'll get Young Skin for Life as a free gift.
Remember, you can try the healing foods free for 21 days. So call now.
Call 1-800-821-2107.
Spring weather, sunny to stormy in a flash. Get detailed reports at 95 cents a minute by calling 1-900-WEATHER. Now, the spring weather update.
And here is your spring weather update, where we've got some very spring-like weather. That means severe weather. We've had a lot of reports of that today from Mississippi, Alabama, in the Georgia area, hail up to the size of golf balls, and a line extended very far to the north, a report of a tornado in southeastern Iowa, and some hail in central Illinois. From here on out, still the potential for some strong thunderstorms exists, not as much in the Great Lakes. I think mainly confined to, say, the Tennessee Valley, south and east into the Carolinas, the most likely areas to get that type of weather. And the reason is we've got a cold front that's just hardly moving at all. More disturbances rotating around. This big storm will hit that moist air and cause some nasty thunderstorms. As the moisture, though, is getting thrown back around the low into colder air, we're getting a fair amount of snow. We'll talk about that in just a bit. First, though, I want to show you radar in the southeast part of the country, kind of pinpoint the active weather here. One area of thunderstorms moving into the Carolinas. Had a lot of rain in Carolina mountains. Looks like they're getting a fair amount more as we speak. Thunderstorms down into Florida. Second line of storms now redeveloping in Alabama and Mississippi. And this kind of scenario could go on tonight, right on into tomorrow. So we'll keep a close eye on this part of the country. We're talking about the backside of that storm, snow. Some of that has been heavy. Look at some of these amounts. Unprecedented for this time of year. Nebraska City, Nebraska, a foot of snow. Omaha, 8 inches of snow. And even as far south as Kansas City, Missouri, 2 inches of snow. And really, the area of snow is not going to move all that much as the low is just almost stationary or even drifting a little westward. So these same areas will continue to get it, and some areas could be looking at a foot of snow, of wet snow, and some travel problems, or some of the rain in the colder air will be heavy, and the thunderstorms, too, could dump a fair amount of rain in the east. As that front will be slow to move along, so will the low, so the snow will continue to fly. Let's see what's going to be happening along the west coast as we head on into tonight and tomorrow. We do have a front. You can see the clouds associated with it, but not much in the way of precipitation. A few scattered showers, but it is going to turn the winds more onshore. That should cut back on the warm temperatures we've been seeing along the coast of California. That was the case today in San Francisco, and even L.A. and San Diego will cool down just a bit as we head on into tomorrow. Current temperatures still rather mild, but as you head on up the coast, they do cool down a bit. San Francisco at 57, Astoria at 47 degrees. But again, the big weather around this low pressure system, and that's going to be a rough go in the east. For the west, though, just a kind of a weak front dropping its way on to the southeast, a few scattered showers in the mountains, maybe a shower behind the system, a little unstable in the northwest, and the onshore flow will cut back on the heat a bit in Southern California. Some gusty winds along the coast, though, near the San Francisco Bay. Here's a look at your lows with some clouds along the coast, but a fair amount of afternoon sunshine, although not quite as warm as the past couple of days along the coast. Interior sections like Palm Springs will get just about as warm. San Francisco, 53 to start the day with a few clouds around, a little patchy fog, but sunny for the afternoon and real nice. 66 in San Francisco, Sacramento up to 77, Fresno at 84 degrees. It's still a little unsettled in the northwest. We'll call it partly cloudy skies, maybe a stray shower. Most areas though are going to be dry, and your temperatures generally getting into the 50s. We'll check road conditions and radar coming up shortly.
It's the time to rely on weather features which only the Weather Channel can bring. What does this season have in store for you? Spring Weather Update provides conditions on changing temperatures and chances of precipitation.
Planning your weekend? Catch the Weekend Outlook for the extended forecast. Enjoy the shore? Boat and Beach Report gives you a thorough forecast on all water, wind, and sun conditions. Springtime and the Weather Channel. Every hour, blossoming with unique weather features.
Now, your local forecast, accurate and dependable from the Weather Channel.
What would the classroom be like without cable? Cable companies across America have made a commitment to provide free service and programming to every secondary school in their communities. Cable contributes to life.
And now it's time for the Michelin Drivers Report, brought to you by Michelin and your participating Michelin dealers.
Still raining, and a cold rain at that, in parts of the north and central Great Plains. There is, in fact, a flood watch in effect for parts of extreme eastern Minnesota and western Wisconsin as the rains are coming down pretty hard there. There's also some snow, a wet snow at that, falling in western parts of the state of Iowa. Thunderstorm activity could approach strong levels still in this general area. In fact, we don't think the southeast is completely out of the woods until late afternoon, at least on Tuesday. That front really has slowed down in the mid-Mississippi Valley. And at this hour, storms are still firing up in eastern Mississippi and Louisiana, a few thunderstorms, and into western Alabama. Well, those will continue to rumble through parts of the south overnight into part of Tuesday as well. Snow on a northerly wind beginning to break out. A wet snow into eastern Nebraska and western Iowa. Some record snowfall amounts already have fallen there for so late in the season. And rainy travel can be generally expected with those storms in various locations in the southeast and across extreme northern New England, with winds to 30 miles per hour plus as the circulation around that storm continues to spin.
For regional Michelin drivers reports, call the Weather Channel Connection, 1-900-WEATHER.
Ah, a new arrival. A tire so special, it may last as long as you own your car. The new XH4. Congratulations, it's a Michelin. Backed by an 80,000-mile treadwear limited warranty. Michelin. Because so much is riding on your tires.
Find Michelin tires at this dealer near you, because so much is riding on your tires.
You'll get more than just your common garden variety weather when you watch Garden Weather right here on the Weather Channel. Weather you can always turn to.
At this hour, thunderstorms are continuing to rumble in parts of the southeast. They're not completely out of the woods and will not be out of the woods until late Tuesday afternoon as a front in the lower Mississippi Valley continues its slow trek on towards the east. Those storms firing up, some rain through parts of Wisconsin and wet snow still occurring in parts of the central and northern Great Plains. Now, the upper-level energy that is swinging through Texas, we think, will continue to work on this air mass in the southeast. Some unstable air remains, and we hope you'll join us frequently on the Weather Channel as we think more strong thunderstorms are a possibility. The timing might not exactly be perfect for big thunderstorms, western Georgia, Alabama, or parts of Tennessee, but farther on towards the east, towards coastal locations, and into the Carolinas, there is always a threat, perhaps, of more weather watches being up Tuesday afternoon as that front continues its trek on towards the east. A weak front in the west, otherwise, the Rocky Mountains are looking like they're in pretty good shape right now, as it looks like a nice Tuesday is coming up there.
Conditions. Your local 36-hour forecast from the National Weather Service. The forecast for cities nationwide. Forecast. Your local radar
showing any precipitation and its movement during the past 90 minutes. Intensity is indicated by the color code at the top of the screen. This is the Weather Channel. Weather you can always turn to for accurate, dependable weather forecasts 24 hours a day.
Spring has sprung, and so have the strong thunderstorms. Stay with the Weather Channel. We'll give you the complete details on severe weather.
Of course, you're watching the Weather Channel. Rich Johnson here with my partner, Keith Westerlich, our director, Jimmy Morrell, Tifton, Georgia. Let's show you what's going on. We have severe weather that's breaking out in Texas. We do have a tornado watch in effect for portions of southeastern Texas, southeastern Oklahoma, northeastern Texas, issued by the National Severe Storms Forecast Center from Kansas City. We do have some active weather in this region right now. The latest satellite photograph showing the story today that we'll be looking for, not only today but the next several days. Low pressure here is eventually going to cause more severe weather tomorrow farther east, but flooding rains farther up to the northeast. For instance, Pennsylvania, there's still some snowpack. A lot of the ground is saturated. So with a 1 to 2 inch rainfall that we are expecting, we could be looking at some flooding conditions. Not only Pennsylvania, but other areas of the New England states too, where the snow is rather deep. Could start out of snow in sections of the northeast. Check your local forecast, of course. Looking farther to the southwest, today around Phoenix, I believe it was a little bit after noontime, local time in Phoenix, funnel clouds were sighted. These are the type of weather phenomena that occurs with a cold area of temperatures high in the atmosphere. Normally, these type of funnel clouds don't cause any damage. No damage was reported. Today, Las Vegas, breezy, but it was sunny today. Rather nice day, up near 70 degrees. Las Vegas, New Mexico, different story. Snow today, even occasional thunder shower or thunder snow shower. Looking at the weather scenario, high pressure in the east, nice day today. New York City, right on down to Philadelphia, my hometown of Baltimore, nice day today too. Meanwhile, to the west, high pressure building in. It is going to be a rather nice week. If you like the dry conditions, you like mild weather, if you live anywhere from San Diego or San Francisco to Seattle, a real nice week shaping up. Meanwhile, we're looking for these two storms, one in North Texas, one near International Falls, Minnesota, to combine, move south to Chicago, and then eventually bring the rain to the east. The latest on our radar showing the situation, and look at all the weather out there. There's a lot of rain developing through Illinois, right on back into areas of Indiana. But first of all, where the action is, it's in Texas. Two areas of bad weather. One now to the south side of Fort Worth, another area showers and storms intensifying up toward the Red River. We'll take you in closer. Here's the Fort Worth area. Here's Dallas, a line of heavy storms rolling on through. The heaviest of these storms now down toward Johnson County. In fact, as we put this into motion, you can see the east-southeast drift of these thunderstorms. If you're taking 35 west, especially heading south of Fort Worth, look out for strong gusty winds, possibility of large hail, and you can't rule out the situation with an isolated tornado. Looking into Arkansas, from Little Rock to Blytheville, looking for scattered showers here, locally heavy rains with some thunderstorms. Farther
all we're getting right now is the rainfall, which is pretty well needed across much of the south. But we do see some stronger thunderstorms here. That's just to the southwest of Gainesville, Florida. And we've got some strong storms, too, in western North Carolina and South Carolina. And both of those have been producing some heavy rainfalls. We've been getting some reports of flooding in western North Carolina because they've been seeing a lot of rain in a short period of time. On the flip side of the coin, as we take you a little further toward the north, we've got light rain, Ohio and Michigan. And then here's a stronger storm in western areas of Wisconsin. But then this changes on over to snow, and we've got a very winter-like scenario here, which we'll discuss in a moment. But there's still the potential for some severe weather in a few areas of the country tonight across northern Wisconsin and Michigan and portions of the southeast. We still have very unstable conditions, so the possibility of some thunderstorms erupting is likely. We've got very warm, moist air ahead of this system, and back behind it, we've got winter-like conditions, believe it or not. Here it is mid-April, and unbelievable snows have been falling in western edges, or actually eastern areas, of Nebraska this evening, and they'll likely continue through the rest of the night tonight. So there are some winter storm warnings that remain in effect for this section of the country. Check out some of the snowfall totals we've seen today. Pretty impressive. Nebraska City, Nebraska, a foot. Omaha, 8 inches. Vince will be along next to discuss whether or not we'll see more snow.
Once again, Vince Miller with you, and quite an active weather day. And interestingly, we'll take a look at this. We have a swirl in the clouds here, intense area of low pressure, both surface and aloft. In fact, the surface low is down to around 29 and a quarter inches of mercury, and that's pretty low. If you take a look at your home barometers, it's up over the northern sections of Iowa right now, and to its west, we are looking at tremendous amounts of snow along the Missouri River. In fact, record-setting amounts of snow. Well, look at some of these totals. Let's show you just how much is on the ground already. Nebraska City, southeast Nebraska, 12 inches of snow. Omaha, north Omaha, northwest side of the city, that's an all-time record. That's the heaviest they've ever seen in terms of snow for not only so late in the month of April, but for so late in the season. Sydney, Iowa, half a foot of snow, even down in Kansas City, Missouri, International Airport in Kansas City, and nearby St. Joseph, Missouri, 2 inches of snow, an awfully lot of snow indeed. Is it going to stick around? Well, not that long, because of course we're in the time of year when we see some significant changes in the weather, and the jet stream pattern is going to be changing significantly, and as the jet stream pattern changes, that is going to be, well, warming things up very nicely. Let's show you what we mean here as we take a look at our forecast here. Jet stream pattern, big swirl in the clouds like this right now, driving that low pressure area northward, but as we work our way through the next several days, the jet stream is going to be flowing more west to east across the country. That will warm things up and give us a period of tranquility after we get rid of this system here. Here it goes, only very slowly north and northeastward. Right now it's moving north-northwestward, but that should shift more north and northeastward with time. Look at this, still a little bit of wet snow there, sort of unusual for this time of year. Cold front takes its merry time pushing eastward because it doesn't have a whole lot of westward input to push it to the east. Westward input meaning westerly winds at the surface. Most of the energy is way up north there. Here comes a weaker system, and although this will be bringing some rains perhaps on top of the snow, portions of the Missouri River Valley later on in the week, the rainfall amount should be very light. Best chances of significant precipitation, again, being focused by the cold front and that low pressure system, both surface and aloft. And again, out here in parts of the Missouri River Valley, that heavy, wet snow will continue to fall. In fact, near blizzard conditions in Omaha tonight. Midnight shift. Most of the midnight shift workers didn't report to work. The roads are that treacherous. So those folks in the National Weather Service forecast office in Omaha who were working the afternoon and evening shift, yeah, lots of overtime tonight. Many instances can't get home anyway. Okay, look at this. Low temperatures, very cold. In fact, there are some frost and freeze warnings out here for portions of the west central high plains. You jump across the frontal boundary and it's very mild indeed, and we continue with that same type of temperature contrast across the front. Stays chilly up here, but look at the warm-up. Yeah, the snow is just simply going to be a memory, but certainly quite an April snowstorm for some folks here. It was the heaviest snow of the winter season. Yeah, it fell during the latter part of April. Okay, here goes the snow out of the picture, and as we work our way through the rest of the week, yeah, tranquility reigns. Well, we'll give you some more information on weather tomorrow night at this same time.
Call the Weather Channel Connection, 1-900-WEATHER. For just 95 cents a minute, you can connect and get the weather for over 900 cities worldwide.
Gardeners, if you love fresh-tasting vegetables and big, beautiful flowers, but think results like this take too much time and too much back-breaking work, here's great news. Introducing the affordable Troy-Bilt Junior, designed especially for smaller gardens. Just look at the time and work the Junior will save you. It's so easy to prepare perfect, ready-to-plant seed beds. Plus, working organic matter into your soil is a snap. Spot-till areas for beautiful flower gardens and borders. Why, you can even use the Junior to reseed your lawn or ring fruit trees. You'll be amazed at how much time and work the Junior will save you. So if you want to learn more about getting results like this, the fast, easy Troy-Bilt way, call now to receive your free Troy-Bilt catalog.
For your free catalog featuring the Junior and our whole line of Troy-Bilt tillers, including our no-money-down easy payment plan, call toll-free 1-800-441-3434. Operators are standing by. That's 1-800-441-3434. Call now.
If you're about to travel, watch the 5-Day Business Planner here on the Weather Channel at 20 minutes after every hour. You get a comprehensive national report that covers the forecast over the next 5 days. Watch the 5-Day Business Planner coming up soon on the Weather Channel. Now, your local forecast, accurate and dependable from the Weather Channel.
Well, now it's time to focus in on what's been happening in the western United States. So let's start off with our satellite picture first. And as we put it into motion, you'll notice that the clouds have been increasing across the west. Started off the day with a fair amount of sunshine in central and southern areas of California. Frontal system moved on through, though, and we saw the clouds thickening as that system did. Most of what we saw across Washington today and Oregon and northern California as well, high thin clouds. And we didn't see a great deal of rain out of this particular system. But we've got yet another series of little weak disturbances that are going to move through. So it looks like the potential still exists, though not through the evening hours tonight necessarily, but through the day tomorrow, especially in the northwest, for some rain. Much of the southwest today, very, very mild, lots of sunshine. Let's go ahead and check out our current surface scenario and show you high pressure is still raining pretty much over much of the west, but it's beginning to weaken and allow this frontal system to slip on through. Again, you can see the scattered light rain, but it's just been really, really light. Hardly notice it at all today. A little bit cooler, yeah, Northern California and on into portions of Oregon, but not a great deal cooler. Right now, as we check out our visible satellite picture, you can see pretty extensive the cloudiness. Now, most of this is high clouds, not creating much in the way of rainfall again. Now, we did see a mild day in spite of the clouds throughout much of this area. We saw our afternoon highs generally into the 60s, a little bit cooler at Coos Bay and Astoria. They were in the 50s. Stampede Pass, of course, one of our cooler spots, 43 degrees. A little bit warmer toward Boise, they saw a bit more sunshine. They were ahead of that front for most of the day today, so they warmed up to 75. Right now we're looking at our temperatures in the 40s and 50s. Stampede Pass now already down to 36 degrees. Northern California, very mild day. Temperature in Merced today, 92. Sacramento and Marysville both made it up on it at 80. A little bit cooler effects, though, of the ocean holding our temperatures into the 60s for San Francisco and for Monterey, where we saw temperatures there in the 60s. Now they're down into the 50s with mostly 60s through the valleys and 73 at Fresno presently. You can see the cloudiness across the northern half of California. But again, this has been pretty high-level clouds. Lots of sunshine today across Southern California, and it was a hot one, as you would expect, especially in the deserts. Palm Springs, 96, now down to a very warm 80. Otherwise, our temperatures, 70s, 60s, and a few 50s. Santa Barbara, 59 degrees presently. Look at our current surface map, and we're still watching this very slow-moving storm system in the central sections of the country, and we still have very active weather out ahead of it. The severe weather seems to have died down for the evening. But back behind this system, we have seen unbelievable amounts of snow. Here it is, mid-April, and Omaha, Nebraska today has seen more snow than they'd seen much of the winter time, as they picked up over 7-8 inches of snow some locations. And there are winter storm warnings in effect for eastern Nebraska through the evening.
Liberace has been crowned Mr. Showmanship. His incomparable style has earned him 6 gold records and 2 Emmys. Liberace is even listed in the Guinness Book of World Records. And now, America's legendary showman is captured in the best of Liberace for the first time on TV.
Hey, I'm glad you like the car. It really stops traffic when I shop at Safeways.
From the dancing waters to his trademark candelabra, it's a dazzling spectacle filled with lavish sights and sounds. This is a rare insider's look at the magical lifestyle of Liberace.
Every time I wear this, I think of what Mae West once said when she said, "Too much of a good thing is wonderful."
It's all the glamour, the excitement, and fun that made Liberace America's legendary showman. The best of Liberace on VHS is only $19.95 plus $3.95 postage. This video is not available in any store at any price. Order now.
Avoid unpleasant surprises when you travel. Watch international weather. Accurate weather forecast for Europe at 41 after the hour, every day on the Weather Channel.
Here's a look at some interesting weather. Though some weather changes again, heading on towards portions of the Missouri River Valley, where we are looking at a record late season snowstorm for at least some folks. 8 inches plus of snow already in Omaha, Nebraska. The latest previous record snow of record for both the month of April and actually the season was barely over 2 inches. Well, we're about 8 and still growing. In fact, The Weather Service folks there at the North Omaha Airport, where the forecast office is in Omaha for the state of Nebraska, most of those folks going to spend the next shift there till, 7 in the morning, roughly. In fact, they called a number of the midnight shift workers, particularly those that lived a ways away, and said, "Hey, stay at home. The roads are supposed to be terrible in Omaha." Amazing have to wait till the end of April to essentially have the biggest snow of the season. Near blizzard conditions, if it weren't for the temperatures, it would be in some instances a blizzard. We're looking at wind gusts in some cases getting pretty close to 50 miles per hour now. Intense low pressure, the center of which is down to around 29.5 inches of mercury, and it's still deepening. But right now it's working its way north-northwestward across north-central Iowa into south-central Minnesota, but we think eventually it'll start moving back to the north and northeast. But as you can see, not a quick mover by any means at all. And with not a whole lot of westerly winds to push this cold front eastward, this cold front to take its merry time pushing eastward. Pretty good temperature contrast across either side of the front here with some frost or freeze warnings out here for this general section of the plains. And look at these highs we're forecasting, only 30s and 40s. Incredibly cold for this time of year. 40s for highs, even deep into Missouri and northeastern Kansas again. But again, jump across the frontal boundary and very mild eastern sections of the country. Look at the warm-up here, though. That snow, not to stick around real long, but a mess while it has been around, that is for sure. Okay, precipitation, still a little bit of snow perhaps up here, parts of the upper Midwest come Wednesday. Still some rains right along the East Coast and Northeast and New England. Then as we head into the rest of the forecast period, not a whole lot to tell you about, a much weaker system, not a whole lot of moisture to work with. But the weekend, fairly quiet.
Temperatures today across the western United States just a little bit cooler than they were yesterday, but still very mild for this time of year. Tomorrow, the forecast up next.
I felt like I never had enough time to have a good, honest workout.
Cast on the Weather Channel.
Frontal boundary is bringing rain to the southeast. Meanwhile, the northeast and midwest are getting a taste of fall.
Conditions. Quilly, you're probably seeing a shower to start off the day, but greater chance for showers as we head into the afternoon hours. Spokane, 59 with some rain. Same with Yakima. Even down into Portland, we could be seeing a scattered shower too. But Burns and Medford staying mostly sunny and temperatures there in the 60s.
World travelers get weather forecasts for over 200 international cities at the touch of a button from the Weather Channel Connection. 95 cents a minute. Just remember 1-900-WEATHER.
Showers, thunderstorms. Take a look at what we've been looking at over the last 7 hours across the, well, southern and southeastern sections of the country. Come on in, radar loop. Yeah, look at this. Big thunderstorms. This is a squall line of thunderstorms way ahead out of the main cold front, which is back. I tell you what, let's take it back 7 hours. Here's the cold front right here, but it's not showing a whole lot of movement. In fact, more showers and thunderstorms have been developing now over parts of Mississippi and Alabama, as you can see. Could be rather wet here again across parts of the south over the next 24 to 36 hours. Thunderstorms, yeah, portions of the Carolinas, scattered across Georgia. In fact, we'll focus into this section of the country right now, show you some of the storms too, down over portions of North Florida, off to the east and south of Gainesville. Showers and storms not as intense though here as they were several hours ago. As we work our way to the north though, this is all snow here, still heavy and blowing at times, and still some thunderstorms out here.
Is the Weather Channel, weather you can always turn to for accurate, dependable weather forecasts 24 hours a day.
Now here's a look at what's going on in western sections of the country, where again the weather is certainly a lot more tranquil than it is further to the east as we work our way east of the Rockies, and we can just see the western edge of a big storm system that's brought record late snow for the season. Parts of eastern Nebraska, northeastern Kansas, probably even into northwestern Missouri, upwards to a foot of snow already. Nebraska City in southeastern Nebraska. We've got clouds here, and you know, pretty good little storm system wound up here over the Gulf of Alaska, but not major amounts of precipitation by any means at all, as far as the western sections of the country are concerned. Enhance the clouds here. We'll go ahead and take you back about 30 hours in time, and as we do so, you can see some of that moisture moving onshore, but again, most of what you're looking at least as affects the lower 48, is just simply either mid-level clouds or high-thin cirrus clouds. Certainly nothing to get all that excited about or concerned about. in terms of significant amounts of widespread precipitation. Fast-moving jet stream, as you can see, the clouds are racing onshore, but in most instances, several tens of thousand feet above sea level. Let's go back down to the surface and show you where the cold front lies. Here it is, a little bit of precipitation, but again, emphasized just a little bit, not amounting to that much. Highs today in the west, again, were certainly easy enough to take with readings in the 70s in Boise and Reno, for example, mid-60s in Salt Lake City, 60 in Lander. Yeah, look at this. Now, this is correct. High in Wollaston, North Dakota today, only freezing. High in Pierce, South Dakota, 31 degrees, hard to believe. High in Bismarck, North Dakota today, by the way, was 28. And that 28 for Bismarck is the latest coldest high, or coldest ever for a high temperature for so late in the season. You know, there were a bunch of days this winter season, particularly the latter part of the winter, when Bismarck was a lot warmer than 28 degrees. Near 70 in San Francisco today, but nothing like the low 80s that you had yesterday. Here's a look at the current temperatures as we check out Southern California. Some of the desert locations still 70s to near 80 degrees. Further northward, 56 now. San Francisco's airport, 61. Sacramento, 66 up in Marysville. And as we head into the Pacific Northwest, lower elevation readings west of the Cascades, 40s and 50s, 36 at pass level at Stampede Pass. Here's a look at the current surface map. Intense low pressure. Central pressure is less than 29.25 inches of mercury now. That's pretty low. Quite a storm system indeed, with record-breaking snow back here into portions of eastern Nebraska. Omaha thus far at the North Omaha office, 8 inches of snow and still coming down pretty heavily. Lincoln, Nebraska, 5 inches of snow. That 8 inches at Omaha, by the way, has been surpassed by a couple more inches than that in other parts of the city. The day shift, well, afternoon, evening shift of the forecasters there, meteorologists at the office, most of them spending the night. Roads are bad. In fact, most of the midnight shift, from what we're told, not report to work because of the significant amount of wind and snow. Cold, too, with these temperatures way below normal, but out in the warm sector of the storm, temperatures way above normal. Near 80 again in Pittsburgh. It was 82 in Erie, Pennsylvania, a record for the date for those folks. But 28 again in Bismarck, coldest you've ever been for so late in the season for a high temperature. In fact, 28, the high, was 5 degrees cooler than the average low for this time of year. Now down to 23 in Bismarck, 30 in Grand Island, 33 in Kansas City, where they had 2 inches of snow at the International Airport. Here a look, the latest national radar. Let's put this in motion just real quickly here, and we can show you that, yes, indeed, this is all snow here, and it's still coming down very heavily. Okay, our forecast, let's check it out. Western sections of the country where we have a cold front out here, and as we check out the cold front, a little bit of precipitation, but certainly nothing to get all that concerned about. A really pretty weak system, widespread heavy rain simply are not in the forecast. Here's a look at our forecast as we work our way on up the coast. The readings near 100 again at the desert areas. Again, temperatures easy enough to take in the interior valley, 70s and 80s. And finally, into the Pacific Northwest we'll go, where we'll see maybe a few isolated showers, but again, key in and isolated. They really are not going to be amounting to that much at all by any means. Jet stream, well, goes zonal, means more or less the flow in the upper atmosphere is from west to east, and that means not much in the way of storminess. After we get rid of this current storm that's responsible for this cold up here in the Midwest, but there goes the snow with high temperatures in the 60s as we work our way on past midweek. Here's a little snow left in the forecast, parts of the Midwest on Wednesday, but then we take a look at a much weaker system working across the plains towards the Ohio River Valley by Friday. By the first of the weekend, most of the country dry and tranquil.
This spring, you can learn all the ground rules for gardening on the Weather Channel. How will your garden grow? Watch our Garden Weather, featuring accurate planting calendars, telling you just when the time is ripe for planting. Our frost-free advisories will keep you up to date on the last freezes and the threat of spring frosts. And
it lasts as long as a Michelin.
You'll trust it like a Michelin. Well, they can try anything they want. Because once you've owned a Michelin tire, there's nothing anyone can do to talk you out of one.
Find Michelin tires at this dealer near you, because so much is riding on your tires.
You get more than just your common garden variety weather when you watch Garden Weather right here on the Weather Channel. Weather you can always turn to.
Let's go ahead and check out our national radar and show you what's been happening around the country. We've been watching our thunderstorms across the south dying down, still seeing some rain in the Ohio Valley, and the snow continues across the upper Midwest. First, we'll take you down into the southeast, where we've been watching some strong storms just to the southeast of Macon. And another line of showers has developed now from Huntsville down toward Tuscaloosa and back toward Mobile. None of these particularly strong or severe, thank goodness. And across the east, the rainfall remains generally light to moderate, moving off in a northeasterly direction now. As we take you a broader perspective of the south, we've been watching some strong storms near Gainesville this evening and some heavier rains in western North Carolina and South Carolina, and some heavy snows into the upper Midwest. Snowfall reports in some areas of eastern Nebraska, 12 inches or more. Omaha, for instance, has picked up over 8 inches of snow, and that will continue through the evening hours tonight.
Watching the Weather Channel. Weather you can always turn to for accurate, dependable weather forecasts 24 hours a day.
Much of the rain at this hour, generally in the eastern part of the country, as a storm is continuing to spin its way on towards the central Great Lakes. The storm, by the way, has had quite a history. It's not done yet. Snow is now falling unusually far south at this time of the year into Iowa and parts of Minnesota. And elsewhere, it's raining pretty hard. A little bit too warm to snow into Minnesota, but the rain's coming down fairly hard. And in the southeast, occasional rounds and lines of thunderstorms creating some flooding conditions in a few areas. Again, the threat of strong thunderstorms until the wee hours in the morning in parts of Alabama and Georgia. and more will likely fire up during Tuesday afternoon. Where it has already rained, there will be a problem also with some fog, while the snows will continue in parts of eastern Nebraska and western Iowa. Already a solid half foot of snow on the ground in some areas, and they're having a big problem around Omaha with this late season snow. And the winds 2 to 30 miles per hour from the north, funneling down the central and northern Great Plains as low pressure is working its way into the central Great Lakes at the present time. And yes, the fog, with that old front still more or less hung up in this position, the fog locally thick with the cooler nighttime hours, but we think the April sun is strong enough so that we'll have some sunshine breaking through from the nation's capital, Baltimore and Philadelphia, on towards southern New England by the afternoon hours on Tuesday. Well, the national map still shows that low pressure area grinding its way on towards the western Great Lakes. Yes, cold enough for some snow as far south as the central Great Plains. And here's that cold front, we think, early Tuesday morning. It will bring with it occasional showers and storms. The air mass still unstable enough so that some of those storms could approach fairly strong levels during the day as the front continues its trek on towards the east. And the snows at that point will be continuing in parts of the western and northern Great Plains. On the west coast, things pretty quiet. Weak front more or less stalled out in central California, a scattering of showers farther to the north and west. And that low will continue to bring some occasional rains to the mid-Atlantic states, Richmond and Pittsburgh. Watch out for afternoon thunderstorms and the rainfall amounts in some areas 3 inches plus from eastern Georgia and the Carolinas on north. Not everybody will get those kinds of rains, but in some isolated areas, there could very well be enough to cause some flooding. And there it is in that very small area of western Iowa, 6 to 12 inches of April snow in some areas, the latest it has ever snowed that much ever. The records go back over 100 years. Well, your overnight lows as a result will drop to the 20s and 30s. There are freeze and frost advisories up for parts of Texas, Oklahoma, and western Kansas. Won't be snowing there, perhaps, but there very well could be freezing temperatures. And the highs on Tuesday also will only be in the 30s and 40s on the west side of that low pressure area, as compared to 70s and 80s on the east side, and very warm temperatures in the desert southwest, including Southern California, getting on towards 90 degrees plus. Palm Springs east of Blythe could get up close to 100. So summer's not too far away. And our jet stream shows more or less a normal pattern right now, the moisture being fed in from the Pacific, the jet stream winds then careening up into eastern Canada. That will keep the warmth in through Wednesday, it looks like, in the northeast. There are some signs, perhaps, that the jet stream will sag again during the weekend. You could get back into another one of those patterns with that cold ocean wind and high pressure to the north, bringing in a chill off the waters, and low clouds and fog may redevelop. So enjoy the warm weather while it lasts. We could have a little bit of a reversion back to the way things were. Cold air again Wednesday, then the April sun will go to work and begin to modify the air mass in the Great Lakes a bit, and also the temperatures Thursday and Friday in the nation's heartland will start to warm, including the desert southwest. 70s and 80s Saturday in the southeast, including Florida. 40s and 50s in the Great Lakes and on the coolish side of New England, but perhaps briefly into the 60s. We'll see how far south that cold air gets. We'll keep you informed, of course. Here's a look at the map as we'll look on Wednesday, with perhaps a heavy soaking rain throughout the northeast Wednesday, some lingering rain activity into North Florida, drying out to the west with a scattering of rain and snow into the Rocky Mountains. A couple of thunderstorms in North Texas, and on towards northern New England on Thursday. Friday, more or less on the dry side, coast to coast. And Saturday, too, a couple of scattered showers in the northwest, a few more showers in the northeast. Not a major storm. In fact, the weekend is looking dry for much of the country, but cold in the northeast.